I have some new iPad apps that I've been trying out that I want to share with you all. This video is sponsored by Scrintal. Let's get into it. First up is Busycal. My Fantastical subscription expired last month. And while I do think Fantastical is a very great app, like it's very well made and it's a very good looking app too, it's a bit pricey and I don't live out of my calendar. I need a calendar app, but it's not one of the core apps I work from every single day. Ideally, a calendar for me should show me the handful of meetings and appointments I have every week, plus the Formula One schedule. Plus, I'd like it to have the ability to show the tasks from my task manager in the calendar view as well. I really like having everything laid out in one app, all my appointments, meetings, tasks. That's just really handy to me. In Busycal, you can sign into all of your accounts you expect, like Google Calendar and iCloud. You can also sign into Todoist or connect reminders to it, and it'll display all of your tasks in there. Plus, you can add web meeting services like Zoom or WebEx as well. With Busycal, you get a lot of features you would expect with Fantastical, but it's a flat one-time $10 purchase. There are features like calendar sets so you can pick which of your calendars are showing at a given time. Just like with Apple's calendar app or Fantastical, you can use the focus filter feature to automate this. There is a traditional day, week, and month view, but it also includes a list view for seeing both tasks and appointments in a top-down list, and there is just a single task view as well. I really like the ability to connect a task manager to my calendar. I've been running some experiments with Todoist and have all my tasks with due dates showing up in Busycal. This lets me lay out my whole week and helps me balance tasks and meetings. I have a really bad habit of stacking a bunch of stuff on Mondays and my week just is completely off balance and I end up spending Monday morning trying to rebalance my week. Busycal has solid natural language support for creating appointments in the calendar. It even supports the / command Fantastical has for changing the calendar it's being added to. Busycal is the best non-subscription calendar app I've come across for the iPhone and iPad. And if you're somebody like me that doesn't need all like the crazy enterprise features of a calendar app, Busycal will be perfect and it'll get the job done for you. Now there is one other calendar experiment I've been doing. I mentioned my Fantastical subscription ran out. I did not renew that. But there is a free tier for Fantastical. So I've been running that alongside Busycal, and so far it's going really good. The only feature I'm really missing from the subscription is calendar sets. That's something I use quite a bit. When I first started running this, it reminded me a lot that, hey, you should upgrade to the paid tier. Like, it was multiple times a day I was getting that pop-up. It seems to have slowed down quite a bit. Like, I'm not getting that as much. Like, I'll get it like every couple of days, which can still be annoying, but that has slowed down quite a bit. Now, that being said, the $10 version of Busycal is a lot more full-featured than the free version of Fantastical, and a little less annoying because you don't get pop-ups. And in iPadOS, I just love the way Fantastical works with slide over and split view. It just resizes a lot nicer. Plus, it's just so well designed. Ticci Tabs is a really interesting idea for an app. The idea is you probably have 6 or 7 websites you go to all the time. And this is one place that kind of has all of them bookmarked so you can just quickly tap on them to check them out. Right now, I'm using this as a place to quickly check out tech news for the day and a couple of my favorite websites. Some days I'm just way too busy to go through my whole RSS feed. And this way I can get the top level highlights of what happened. What I like about Ticci Tabs is if a site is behind a paywall, you can use your personal link for that site and it will save your login credentials. So my friend and co-host over on Comfort Zone, Matt Berchler, he has a membership portion for his website where he does a few membership posts a week. What's great about this is I was able to take that login link, save that, and that way whenever I go to that, I don't have to re-log in every single time. So nice. Ticci Tabs also has support for tags. Right now I have 2 kinds of sites I'm using this for, news and mechanical keyboards. I use the tabs to separate out the two. I can just check out the news if I want to see what was happening, or if I want to go browsing for mechanical keyboard parts, I can do that as well. While you can absolutely set something like this up with bookmarks, it's nice to have a dedicated app if you really want to focus on just a handful of websites. This video is sponsored by Scrintal. Scrintal is a modern take on note-taking, writing, and even project management. It is a playground for your mind. Scrintal is a Canvas-based work system. In here, you can lay out everything you are working on and planning. You can link documents together, add a task list, build a Kanban board, add image, videos, and PDF documents, and more. When starting off, I have my desk view here. This is kind of your starting point in Scrintal. I've linked everything I am working on here. This supports rich text, so I'm able to lay everything out visually and make it look nice. In here, I have projects like my gear page, tax documents, video projects, and an upcoming Disneyland trip. You can click on any one of these to open the document attached to it. Lately, I have been knee-deep in planning a Disneyland trip for 9 people. If you've ever wanted to test your project management skills, plan a Disneyland trip. With Scrintal, I laid out all the tasks that need to be completed before leaving. I also mapped out everyone's plans, so we have a nice visual way of seeing what's going on. Scrintal also has a built-in AI assistant. So I asked it, what are the best walk-up counters to eat at in Disneyland and California Adventure? It gave me a few recommendations, then I was able to add it into another document called Restaurant Recommendations to save for later. Another document I have is for tracking all of my video projects. I built a Kanban board in here, and I can track everything I am working on and what stage it is in. Since Scrintal is block-based, everything just snaps together. Easy to move one block from one section to another. In each document, I can add a summary of video, sponsor information, and notes. And because Scrintal has a full text editor in it, I could even write my scripts here. I'm just scratching the surface of what you can do with Scrintal. I'm gonna put some links in the description below so you can go check it out. Use the code LOLLY30 to get 30% off your first subscription period. My thanks to Scrintal for sponsoring this video. Raycast is one of my all-time favorite Mac apps, and now it's on the iPhone and iPad. On the Mac, it's a Spotlight replacement, but on the iPhone and iPad, there is no Spotlight replacement APIs. Like, you just can't do that. On the iPad, you can access a handful of Raycast extensions. The big focus is AI chatbots, but there are a ton of those already in the App Store, especially with the official apps like ChatGPT or Gemini. What I like using it for is accessing snippets and quick links. If you pay for the pro version of Raycast, these will sync over from your Mac. If not, you can set them up manually. Raycast does have shortcut actions. I have a simple one-action shortcut that just opens the app right to my text snippets. I have been using this over my snippet cut shortcut lately due to a bug. Right now, Raycast on the iPhone and iPad doesn't do much, especially if you don't want to use it as an AI chatbot. I'm hoping they'll add more features in the future, like syncing your clipboard history over from your Mac. And I would love for them to somehow open the ability for third-party extensions on the Mac to come to the iPhone and iPad. I doubt this will ever happen, but if Apple was to ever open it up so that Spotlight replacements could come to iPadOS, I would immediately be using Raycast over Spotlight, hands down. It's just an extremely powerful utility on the Mac, and the iPad deserves something like that. I would love for something like that to be on the iPad. But for right now, it's been a handy way to get my snippets and quick links. Whisper Transcription has been a core app for me on the Mac. This is how I generate subtitles for my YouTube videos and comfort zones. I hate the auto-generated YouTube subtitles. They are not good at all. Whisper Transcription is here on the iPad now. You can use the cloud model on the iPad, but what makes Whisper Transcription great compared to a lot of other apps is that you can download a local model. On the iPad and iPhone, this will take up about 600 megabytes of space, but you can use the local power of your machine. And if you have an M4 iPad Pro, that's no slouch. Using the local model means you don't have to upload anything to the cloud. And right now there is a 50 megabyte limit with Whisper Transcription for uploading things to the cloud. Now there are a lot of other reasons why you might want to use an app like Whisper Transcription besides video work. If you record your meetings, you can use Whisper Transcription to create a full transcript. You can also use the prompt section to ask questions about the transcript, like any takeaways or action items for you. The only issue is right now the iPad and iPhone version, it looks like they only support audio files. So if you do have a video file, you're going to have to take that and convert it into an audio file or just export the audio version first. The Mac version does support both video and audio. But this works extremely fast. I ran this against a full episode of Comfort Zone that was an hour and 19 minutes long, and it finished transcribing it on my M4 iPad Pro in 5 minutes and 8 seconds. Now, once it's done, you can export full transcripts, segments, or subtitles in an SRT format. And by the way, all of that stuff local. So transcribing everything locally, exporting those files locally, all of that is free. If you want to use the cloud models or the prompts, that's where you need to subscribe, but it is fairly reasonably priced. Streammm with three M's is a lo-fi radio app. I've been using this while I work just to focus and drown out the world around me. Streammm with three M's has four different stations built into it. Lo-fi, which is my favorite, lounge jazz, which is very good as well, roots reggae, and ambient. All of these are very distinct from each other. I was using Apple Music to kind of play lo-fi music, but the problem with that is it messes up your recommendations. With using something like Streammm with three M's, it keeps that separate, so that way it doesn't mess up your recommendations. There is a free plan that you can stream music with. There's also a premium subscription that gives you unlimited streaming, higher audio quality, and a timer setting. If you like this kind of music, whether you're using it to work against or you're just relaxing and don't want to mess up like your streaming music platform's recommendations, I highly recommend checking out Streammm or any other app like this. There's a bunch of apps like this. Doodle Draw is a very simple app. It uses the built-in pencil kit toolset and just gives you a blank page. There's no document management, no import feature to bring in images or PDFs, no grid to line things up. It's basically if you took the Apple Pencil features out of Notes and turned it into its own separate app. It's great for sketching something up or just doodling. I love the simplicity of that. You can export your document to files if you do want to save it for later. Then later you can re-import it again if you want. There is no built-in document management system. It's just a super simple app. It has access to all the tools from PencilKit, the color picker and any colors you save, and Apple Pencil Pro features like barrel roll, hovering palette of tools, and the undo menu. The one thing it doesn't have that I wish it could get is the ability to draw and hold to generate the perfect shape. This is a feature of Apple Notes and Freeform. Speaking of why you'd want to use this over, say, one of those built-in tools. Like I said, it's a much more stripped-down version. If you don't need the heavy features of those other apps and you just want something to draw, something incredibly simple, and that is appealing to you, you literally just want something to doodle in, this is for you. Doodle Draw is also free, so using this over the other apps doesn't really cost you anything. I've been collecting RSS apps like 10-year-olds collect Pokemon. Since the soft retirement of the Reader app, I've been trying to find an RSS app that both looks good and has all the features that I want. And I think I finally found it with Fiery Feeds. This is an extremely customizable RSS reader. Some would say it's too customizable, but I say it's perfect. You can change features like fonts, header, text size, build themes, and more. Now, this is another app that does have a premium subscription, but I've just been using the free tier, and it's perfectly fine for me. I use Feedbin to gather all of my feeds. The system dark theme looks good to me. The only thing I did is I went in and I adjusted what font I was used. I switched it to New York. I also bumped up the text size and the line spacing a bit. I'm officially closer to 40 than I am 20, so I just kind of have to have fonts to be a little bit bigger now. The reading experience is great in Fiery Feeds, especially since I switched to the smaller iPad Pro. I can read both in tablet mode and when I'm sitting on the couch. I use the swipe gestures to jump through. I also read in the morning when I am eating my breakfast. I leave the iPad in the Magic Keyboard and use the arrow keys to move between articles. Overall, a very good RSS app, extremely customizable and a generous free tier. If this is the RSS app that sticks around for me, I will be subscribing to the premium tier just to support the development. The last app I want to talk about is called Quick Reviews. This one is developed by my friend and co-host over on Comfort Zone, Matt Birchler. This is a way of rating and sharing media you consume. It supports movies, TV shows, video games, books, and music. Plus, it has a miscellaneous category for anything that you want. For the first three categories, there is a smart feature, so you can just type the name of the media, and it will then autofill the metadata, including the poster. Then you can just rate and review the content. What I really like about this is it's not trying to be another platform. We really don't need another one of those. Instead, it's a place to where you can organize everything that you've consumed, and then it gives you these nice cards that you can share to the platforms that you're already on. If you use the service Letterboxd, you can actually hook your account up to Quick Reviews. This way, if you rate something in Letterboxd, it will then create a card for you automatically in Quick Reviews. Then you can post that wherever you want. Now, full disclosure, Matt is a friend of mine, but I think this is a really clever app. If you're somebody that wants to share what you consume and share what you enjoy, really, this is a great way of doing that. Now, it is free to try it out, so go give it a whirl. So those are a few apps that I've been using on my iPad. I'll put links to everything in the description below, but I want to hear from you all. Do you have any new iPad app recommendations? Let me know in the comments below. My thanks to Scrintal for sponsoring this video. If you liked the video, hit the thumbs up button, subscribe if you haven't already, and have a great day.